et nostri omnipotens Deus, et dimissis peccatis nostris, reducat nos ad vitam eternam.
Thank you.
instantes obsequium, digne corpus satisfactionis exhibiamus officium, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
A reading from the prophet Ezekiel. The Lord God says this, I am going to look after my flock myself and keep all of it in view. As a shepherd keeps all his flock in view when he stands up in the middle of his scattered sheep, so shall I keep my sheep in view. I shall rescue them from wherever they have been scattered during the mist and darkness. I shall bring them out of countries where they are. I shall gather them together from foreign countries and bring them back to their own land. I shall pasture them on the mountains of Israel, in the ravines and in every inhabited place in the land. I shall feed them in good pasturage. The high mountains of Israel will be their grazing ground. There they will rest in good grazing ground. They will browse in rich pastures on the mountains of Israel. I myself will pasture my sheep. I myself will show them where to rest. It is the Lord who speaks. I shall look for the lost one, bring back the stray, bandage the wounded, and make the weak strong. I shall watch over the fat and healthy. I shall be a true shepherd to them. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The love of God has been poured into our hearts by the Holy Spirit, which has been given us. We were still helpless when, at his appointed moment, Christ died for sinful men. It is not easy to die, even for a good man, though, of course, for someone really worthy, a man might be prepared to die. But what proves that God loves us is that Christ died for us while we were still sinners. Having died to make us righteous, is it likely that he would now fail to save us from God's anger? When we were reconciled to God by the death of his Son, we were still enemies. Now that we have been reconciled, surely we may count on being saved by the life of his Son. Not merely because we have been reconciled, but because we are filled with joyful trust in God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have already gained our reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Dominus vobiscum. Lectio Sancte Evangelii secundum Lucam.
Gloria a ti, Domine.
At that time, Jesus told the Pharisees and scribes this parable. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he has lost one of them, does not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the one which is lost until he finds it? And when he has found it, he lays it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he comes home, he calls together his friends and his neighbors, saying to them, "Rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost." Just so I tell you, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over the 99 righteous persons who had no need of repentance. Verbum Domini.
Today, in this great feast, we venerate the heart of our Lord as the symbol of his human love, in which God's divine love is revealed to us. Now, in most of the prayers of the Meditations on the Sacred Heart, even those very ancient prayers, it is the woundedness of our Lord's heart which comes to the fore, that heart pierced with a lance and bruised with outrages and blasphemies, is a stark and realistic image of the extent to which Christ loves us. The sufferings which the heart of Jesus endures are not meant to be dwelt upon because of some preoccupation with suffering itself. We don't like suffering, but rather because it is by the wounds to his heart that the extent to which we are loved are demonstrated. And this is no ordinary heart. Christ, who is the image of the unseen God, the icon of the Father, shows us precisely what God's love for us looks like. And it looks like a heart pierced and bruised on account of our sins, yet burning with ardent love for you and for me. The time when we celebrate this feast is very fitting. We have come to the end of the church's celebration of the mysteries of our redemption, the Passion, the Cross, the Resurrection and the Ascension, Pentecost, the Feast of the Blessed Trinity, and Corpus Christi. But today, almost as a sort of a culmination, we commemorate the divine human love which runs right through them all. In adoring the Sacred Heart, we adore the totality of Christ's saving work. It represents the way in which God holds nothing back from us. And in order to share his divine life with us, he reaches down into the very depths of our life, even, especially, where it is painful, difficult to speak of, hidden. And by taking it all and joining it to himself, he scoops us up. He enables us to become like him by sharing our life, and by sharing our pains, he heals us, he sanctifies us, and he strengthens us. Many of the mystics connected with the Sacred Heart speak rather alarmingly of going into that pierced heart, of joining our heart to his, to find refuge in the Sacred Heart of Jesus. The physical imagery is quite amazing because this is the way God chose to reveal the nature of his love to us. It is a sign that we are meant to enter with our love, our sometimes feeble and faltering love. We're meant to enter into that unfathomable love which God brought into our midst in the first place. That image of the wounded heart brings it right down to our level and makes it possible for us, even when we feel quite lukewarm and insecure, when our faith is weak and our trust even weaker, that heart is open to us and seeks us and welcomes us. And his heart welcomes us precisely so that we might become like it. The whole thrust of our Christian life is that we might be conformed to our Savior, that we might resemble him. And in this sense, in the life of our faith, we should ask ourselves continually, does my heart resemble his? The love with which we try and do this can only ever be imperfect. But that is okay, because the Sacred Heart is both the example and the cause of our becoming like him. His love is attractive. It draws us on. The more we consider the love with which our Lord acted and spoke and gave of himself for us, the more we should wish to imitate him. It is truly the school of Christian perfection. And we begin in this school of Christian perfection by prayer. When St. John Henry Newman, our cardinal, chose his motto, he looked to another great oratorian, St. Francis de Sales' Treatise on the Love of God. The phrase he chose and paraphrased as his motto, cor ad cor loquitur, represents for us the central mystery of the prayer that can begin to transform us. St. Francis de Sales has it, truly, the chief exercise in mystical theology is to speak to God and to hear God speak in the bottom of the heart. And because this discourse passes in most secret aspirations and inspirations, we term it a silent conversing. Eyes speak to eyes and heart to heart, and none understand what passes save those that speak. We may be no great shakes at the spiritual life or in prayer, or we may feel that excelling in virtue is for other people, better people than us. But if we can, in the simplest ways, open our poor heart to his Sacred Heart and speak to him as if to a friend, if we can entrust our lives to him and ask him devoutly and sincerely to shape us after the model of that heart which he shows us, then our Christian life will be immensely graced. O Jesus, meek and humble of heart, make my heart like unto thine.
Orati fratres et mem ad vestrum sacrificium acceptabile fiat ad Deum Patrem omnipotentem.
Suscipiat Dominus sacrificium de manibus tuis, ad latum ad gloriam nominis sui, ad utilitatem corpi nostra, totiusque ecclesiae sui sancta.
Respice quesimus Domine, ad ineffabilem cordis dilecti filii tui caritatem, ut quod offerimus sit tibi munus acceptum, et nostrorum expiatio delictorum, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum.
Et cum spiritus
tuo. Sorsum corda. Gratias agamus, Domino Deo nostro. Ere dignum et justum est, equum et salutare, nos tibi sempere tubique gratias agere. Domine, Sancte Pater, omnipotens aeterne Deus, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Qui mira caritate, exaltatus in cruce, pro nobis tradidit semet ipsum, atque de transfixo latere, sanguinem fudit et aquam, ex qua manerent ecclesiae sacramenta, ut omnes ad cor apertum salvatoris attracti, iugiter aurirent, e fontibus salutis in gaudio. Et ideo, cum sanctis et angelis universis, te collaudamus, sine fine dicentes.
Thank you. Dei igitur clementissime, Pater, per Iesum Christum, filium tuum, Dominum nostrum, supplices rogamus ac petimus, uti accepta abias et benedica sic dona ec munera, ec sancta sacrificia illibata, in primis quae tibi offerimus pro ecclesia tua sancta catholica, quam pacificare, custodire, adunare, et regere dinieris toto orbe terrarum. Unum cum famulo tuo, Papa nostro Francisco, et antistite nostro Bernardo, et omnibus ortodoxis atque catholici et apostolici fidei cultoribus. Memento Domine famulorum famularumque tuarum. Et omnium circumstantium, quorum tibi fides cognita est et nota devotio, pro quibus tibi offerimus, vel qui tibi offerunt hoc sacrificium laudis, pro se suisque omnibus, pro redemptione animarum suarum, pro spe salutis et inclumitatis sue, debique erunt vota sua eterno Deo vivo et vero. Communicantes et memoriam venerantes, in primis gloriosis semper virginis Mariae, genitricis Deis Domini nostri, Iesu Christi, sed et beati Iosef justum virgini sponsi, et beatorum apostolorum ac martyrum tuorum, Petri et Pauli, Andrei, Jacobi, Ioannis, Tomi, Jacobi, Filippi, Bartolomei, Mattei, Simonis et Tadei, Lini, Cleiti, Clementis, Sixti, Cornelii, Cipriani, Laurenzi, Christogoni, Ioannis et Pauli, Cosme et Damiani, et omnium sanctorum tuorum, quorum meritis precibusque concedas, ut in omnibus protectionis tui meniam auxilio, per Christum Dominum nostrum, Amen. Angegitor oblationem servitutis nostre, sed et cuncte familiae tue, quesumus Domine ut placatus accipias. Iesque nostros in tua pace disponas, atque ab eterne damnationi nos eripi, et in electorum tuorum iubias greti numerari, per Christum Dominum nostrum, Amen. Quam oblationem tu Deus in omnibus quesumus, benedictam ad scriptam ratam, rationabilem acceptabilemque facere dinieris, et nobis corpus et sanguis fiat, delectissimi filii tui, Domini nostri, Iesu Christi, qui pridi equam pateretur, accepit panem in sanctas ac venerabiles manus suas, et elevatis oculis in celum ad tedem patrem sum omnipotentem, tibi gratias agens, benedixit, fregit, diritque discipulis suis, dicens, accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes, hoc est enim corpus meum, quod pro vobis tradetur. Simili modo postquam genatum est. Accipiens et unc preclarum caricem in sanctas ac venerabiles manus suas. Item tibi gratias agens benedixit, deditque discipuli suis, dicens, accipite et bibite ex eo omnes. Ic est enim calix sanguinis mei, novi et eterni testamenti, qui pro vobis et pro multis effundetur in remissionem peccatorum, hoc facite in meam commemoratione.
Mysterium fidei. Memores Domine nos servi tui, sed et plebs tua sancta, iustem Christi filii tui, Domini nostri, tam beati passionis, nec non et vimferis resurrectionis, sed et in celos gloriosi ascensionis, offerimus preclare maestati tue de tuis donis actatis, ostiam puram, ostiam sanctam, ostiam immaculatam, panem sanctum vitae eternae et calicem salutis perpetue. Supraque propitio ex reino vulturis picere dinieris, et accepta aberi, sicuti accepta aberi dignatus es, munera puri tui justi Abel, et sacrificium patriarchi nostri Abrahe, et quod tibi obtulit summus sacerdos tus Melchizedek, Sanctum sacrificium, immaculatum ostium.
Supplices te rugamus omnipotens Deus, iube hic periferi per manus sancti angeli tui, in sublime altari tuum in conspectu divini maestatis tue, per quod quod ex ac altaris participatione sacrosanctum filii tui corpus et sanguinem sum serimus.
Omni benedictioni celesti et gratia repliamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Amen. Memento etiam Domine femorum famularumque tuarum, qui nos preciserunt cum signo fidei, et dormiunt in somno pacis. Ipsis Domine et omnibus in Christo quiescentibus locum refrigerii, lucis et pacis, ut indulgias deprecamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Amen. Nobis quoque peccatoribus familis tuis de multitudine miserationem tuarum sperantibus, paratem aliquam et societatem donari dinieris, cum tuis sanctis apostolis et martiribus, cum Ioannis, Stefano, Mattia, Barnaba, Ignazio, Alexandro, Marcellino, Petro, Felicitati, Perpetua, Agata, Lucia, Anieti, Cecilia, Anastasia et omnibus sanctis tuis, intro quorum nos consortium non estimator meritis et venie quesmus lagitur admite, per Christum Dominum nostrum, per queme comnia Domine semper bona creas, sanctificas, vivificas, benedicis et prestas nobis.
Per ipsum et cum ipso et in ipso, est tibi Deo Patri omnipotenti, in unitate Spiritus Sancti, omnis honor et gloria, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Recepti salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere.
Pater noster, qui es in caelis,
Domine ab omnibus malis, da propitius pacem in diebus nostris, ut opi misericordiae tui adiuti, et a peccato simus semper liberi, et ab omni perturbatione securi, expectantes beatam spem, et adventum salvatoris nostri, Iesu Christi. Domine Iesu Christe, quid existi apostolis tuis, pacem relinquo vobis, pacem meam do vobis, ne respicias peccata nostra, sed fidem ecclesiae tue, eamque secundum voluntatem tuam pacificare et quadunare dinieris, qui vivis et regnas in saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Semper vobis tuum,
et us spiritus tuo.
Amen.
ejecutolis peccata mundi, beati qui accenum anni vocati sunt.
Domine, non sum dignus, ut intra sum